Hi, Scott here with the Do-It-Yourself Website Blueprint, and in this video I'm going to cover planning, the key to website planning. So the goal is to create a framework for our website that we can easily build our website, we can accommodate our goals and objectives, and our content, and we need to be able to anticipate our needs moving forward. So planning is extremely important, and it's pretty straightforward in theory. But a lot of us miss this one, so I like to keep it as simple as possible so that I have enough information to move forward, but that I don't get overwhelmed and I'm not in that analysis paralysis mode. So let me show you the simple but effective strategy for website planning, and you can do this in any text editor or word processing program, Word or Pages or whatever you use, but I usually use Google Docs because it's online and it's autosave and I can get to it from anywhere. So let me show you that. You can probably see it on my screen now. And what I do is I put together, basically I start with 5 bullets. And my bullets are goals, objectives, competition, call to action, and then content and features. Real quick, let me tell you the difference between a goal and an objective. It's like this. The difference between goals and objectives is stating generalities versus specifics. So goals are big picture and objectives are usually actions that can be measured. For example, a goal might be getting more clients, establishing credibility, providing more information to help prospects make a decision. Where an objective might be contact us, or providing pricing, or testimonials, or liking my fan page, or subscribing to my email newsletter, or purchasing my product or service. Okay, so those are the difference between the goals and objectives. Now, the next piece is competition. In my example, what I've done is I've stated my goals is identifying a problem, sharing the solution to that problem, listing the features and benefits, establishing credibility, providing background, providing some examples of the service that I'm going to provide, and then obviously the goal is to ultimately sell that service. So the objectives are going to be things like providing support for salespeople who are trying to sell this service. And by the way, this service is going to be internet marketing that I'm selling to businesses focused on their local search and their local market. So it's providing support for the sales team, providing a pricing structure, creating demos, adding testimonials. I'll have a blog. That's one of the objectives, to be able to communicate tips and general information to clients. I want to ultimately have a fan page. We'll have an email newsletter so we'll want people to sign up. We'll have videos that prospects can watch videos, and then a call to action for an appointment, and then the ability to order the service or have the salesperson place an order through the website. So what I've done, our third bullet is competition, and what I've done is I've looked at a couple different websites. Rather than reinvent the wheel, I like to leverage what's already out there. But there's a couple websites that I really like. One is this Top Lingo, and these guys, I just like the simplicity of their site. It's just 5 tabs, kind of. The homepage has a video, which is nice. It's got information about the company. It's just, the call to action is get a quote. It's really simple. They establish some credibility with some of the clients that they have here, and they've got a client testimonial, a slideshow, the social media stuff, and contact us form. So it's really simple, and I like that, and I want to keep my site simple as well. The other site that I like is called Wildfire Apps, and it's for Facebook. They do a bunch of cool stuff. But again, I like the simplicity. It's, hey, sign up, log in, watch our video, sign up now. I like that they even put it takes 20 seconds, so it makes me want to sign up. And it's just really straightforward, to the point. And then they've got some more information down below. But again, here's some credibility. They've got some text talking about the things that they do. But for the most part, everything above the fold is really simplistic. So that's the competition. I didn't actually write it down here, but Top Lingo and then this other one, Wildfire. And then my call to action. So this is one of those this is usually the most overlooked aspect of websites. Companies think it's sufficient to have a phone number, but the reality is that users are overwhelmed by content with flashing graphics or poor layout. So unless we provide a clear path guiding them to our desired outcome, they may not do what we want them to do. And so when they come to my website, what I want them to do is I want them to contact me for more information. Okay? And so a consultation, and in this case, for contact me for a consultation, and I want them to do that via a form. And in that form, I want to ask some qualifying questions so that I know if they're truly a prospect or not. And you can see how they've done it. In both of these, it's get a quote, and it will go to a form. And then over here, it's sign up. And again, it's to a form. So that's going to be my primary call to action. And then in terms of content and features, I know that I want sort of a homepage video like the Wildfire site, like both of those sites that I showed you have. Possibly a slider so that I can have multiple videos. I want to have a blog so I can have regular articles, a contact form, an email newsletter, testimonials, and then I want to integrate social media. So this really forms the basis for my website, and I know what my goals are, what my objectives are, what my primary call to action is, and then the content that I'm going to be accommodating. So this is how I do my planning. I keep it simple. Again, I use these five bullet points: goals, objectives, competition and call to action, and then content and my features. And now that I know that, I can get started building and putting my website together. So thanks for watching. I hope this was informative for you, and I'll see you in the next video.